crime bureau, and I will talk about police brutality. Police brutality defined is the use of excessive or unnecessary force by police when dealing with civilians. Excessive use of force means force well beyond what would be necessary in order to handle a situation. Police brutality can be present in a number of ways. The most obvious form of police brutality is physical force. Police officers can use nerve gas, batons, pepper spray, and guns in order to physically intimidate or even intentionally hurt civilians. Police brutality can also take form of false arrest, verbal abuse, psychological limitation, intimidation, sexual abuse, police corruption, racial profiling, political repression, and improper use of tasers. Police brutality has been an issue for many years and remains a major concern for those of the minority group. The practice of police brutality has had a strong effect on the main segment of the American population. Although there has been some progress in education and training and interrogation with the law enforcement population, there are still incidents of racial profiling and police brutality. With continued efforts and corrections of racial injustice, this type of abuse and punishment will lessen when laws move more towards justice for minorities. Doing so will cause less brutalities and deaths to occur and more social justice. What causes police to act like this? Sociologically, police officers commit brutality crimes on civilians due to the social status. It's more likely that we would see an officer brutalizing someone of the lower class who has been accused by someone of the higher class. Psychologically is where education plays a role. Officers who do not have the proper education have been proven to show different ways of taking action. Those who are less educated are more likely to engage in physical contact. Also, the experience of an officer is also a big factor in psychological reasoning. Officers who were newer to the job are more often likely to use excessive force. Over here is just a chart of how force is used. Physical is the most. And then you have firearms, mix, taser, chemical, canine. Conclusion. The issue of police brutality isn't going anywhere. The legislative branch of the government should make laws regarding the good police officers going bad. You cannot have cops wandering the streets pretending nothing is happening when there is always something going on. We cannot allow one's race to prevent the need to help from a police officer. We cannot have misconduct by any police officer. Allow police brutality as part of the norm is like allowing a crook into your house. We must stop for a second and look at our police culture and identify what they think is good or bad. We must evaluate each and every cop on not how much they do, but what and how will they think.